If you create a lot of charts and customize them manually, this is the video for you. My requirement is like this. I have data. I have already created a chart, but I have taken a lot of effort to customize it exactly the way I want. Now, I get more data and I want to create a chart which looks exactly like the way I want. How do you do that? By using chart templates. If I directly create a chart, it's not going to work. So what do I do first? Go to the chart which I've already customized. And I don't want the data to be saved. I want the formatting look and feel to be saved. So right click on it and say save as template. I'm just going to call it template one. I'm also going to copy this path. Save the template. Now, when I want to create a new chart afresh, I click inside the data, go to insert chart, but I don't click on this type of chart. You go to this corner. This is going to open the dialog. It's called a dialog launcher. Now, even here, it'll show you recommended charts. I don't want that. Go to all charts. But I don't want to choose an explicit specific chart type because I already have a template. So this is the template I had saved, template one. I'm going to click on it and apply. So it creates a chart from scratch exactly the way I want. So this is how you standardize the look and feel. You can even share this template with your colleagues. Make sure they save it in the correct path. The default path will be something like this: C colon users, then your user ID and the rest of it. When you send the file to others, ask them to save it in their corresponding folder. Only then it will appear in the list of chart templates. So we seem to have solved the problem, but no, there is a more complex situation. So I have three charts here and three more charts here. I've already created them based on each piece of data. Now I want to apply my custom chart template here. Now if I follow the earlier method, I'll have to go to each chart, right click, change chart type and manually do this six times. I don't want to do that. So I thought must write a macro for this. And instead of writing it myself, I did something different. I went to Copilot. This is the free version of Copilot. And I asked it, give me VBA code to apply a chart template to a chart. Yes, I could have recorded a macro, but this gives you better results. So it gave me the code. I looked at the code and then I realized that applying it to one chart is not what I want. I want it for multiple charts. In fact, all charts in a file. So I continued the conversation and said, how do I apply it to multiple charts? And then it gave me this. This is actually going to define a worksheet, create a chart object, and create a path. So three variables defined. Then this is the generic path given. We have to replace it with the correct path for our template. And then it is going to go through the workbook. Each workbook has sheets and each sheet has charts. So first loop in the workbook, then loop in the chart objects. And then when you find the chart, simply apply chart template using the path we have defined earlier. So copy, and then I went to a blank file. Then I saved it as XLSM because I'm going to create a macro. XLSX cannot store macro. Now, where do you copy paste it? You go to Alt F11. It'll open this, make sure the correct file is chosen. Add a module by going to insert and module, which I've already done. When you create it, it'll be blank, but just copy paste it. And then few corrections have to be done. The path I have pasted based on what my path is. And second thing is, if you look at the original code, it is looking at this workbook. This workbook means the file which contains this macro. But I did not want that because in my chart files, I didn't want the macro. So this is a standalone independent file. So if I say this worksheet, my file has nothing. It's not going to work. So instead of that, I said active workbook. Means what? The workbook which is currently active when I run the macro. And that's all I need to do as changes. When you create the macro, it's a good idea to save it, close it and reopen it, because sometimes the macros are off. And when you open it again, it'll ask you, do you want to enable content, which is like enable macro. Keep this file open. Go to the intended target file. You can click anywhere as long as this is the active file. Now macro, Where is it? View menu, macros. It should show you this macro, but sometimes it doesn't because what is shown in the drop-down matters. If it is something like this, the macro will not be seen. So don't worry, open this drop-down and choose all open macros, or I know that template is this. In either case, you will see it. Highlight it and run it. And that's it. It went through all the charts and it has applied the template perfectly. So this is how you can not only customize and standardize your look and feel, you can also apply it in bulk when you have complex and multiple charts in a single file. So try this out and let me know your feedback. If you liked it, let YouTube also know that you liked it so that it can show it to more people and everyone becomes more efficient. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.